We're told that Imran is 2 years older than Dia. Dia is 2. How old is Imran? So I encourage you to pause this video and try to think about this yourself. How old is Imran given the information here? So let's use some letters to represent Imran and Dia's age. Let's say that I is equal to Imran's age. Imran's age. And let's say that D is equal to Dia's age. D is equal to Dia's age. So given that, what does this first sentence tell us? It says that Imran's age, Imran is 2 years older than Dia. So Imran's age is going to be equal to Dia's age, is going to be equal to Dia's age plus two. That's what this first sentence tells us. Imran's age is Dia's age plus two. Imran is 2 years older than Dia. Another way you could think about it, if we were to imagine their ages on a number line right over here. So if this is 0, and then this is Dia's age right over here. This is Dia's age. Let me do it in that same color. This is Dia's age right over here. If you were to add 2 to Dia's age, so if you were to go 2 more, if you were to go 2 more, so plus 2, you would get to Imran's age. You would get to Imran's age. So that's what this first sentence tells us. Then they tell us that Dia is 2. So that's like saying that D, which we're using to represent Dia's age, that's going to be equal to 2. So this thing is equal to 2. This thing right over here is equal to 2. So we can rewrite this as Imran's age is equal to Dia's age, which we now know to be 2, plus 2. Plus 2. So what's 2 plus 2? Well, you know that. That's going to be 4. So Imran's age is going to be equal to 4. If this is 2 right over here, and then you were to go up 2 more, you're going to get to 4. Imran's age is 4. Let's try one more of these. So here we're told that the giraffe at the zoo is 3 times taller than Shantanu. Shantanu is 6 feet tall. How tall is the giraffe? So once again, I encourage you to pause this video and try to think about it on your own. Let's do the same idea. Let's use some letters to represent the different heights. So G for giraffe and S for Shantanu. So they say the giraffe, and I'll use G for the height of the giraffe. The height of the giraffe is 3 times taller, not 3 more feet, 3 times taller than Shantanu's height. So we could say that the giraffe's height is equal to 3 times Shantanu's height. 3 times Shantanu's height. So just let's be clear what we hit. The G represents the height of the giraffe, S represents the height of Shantanu. So another way of thinking about it, let me see if I can draw a giraffe reasonably here. So if this is the giraffe, actually this isn't a bad job at drawing a giraffe. So if this is the giraffe right over here, they're saying that if you take Shantanu's height times 3, you get to the giraffe's height. So let me make, actually giraffe might have longer legs than that. So this is G, the height of the giraffe is G, and Shantanu's height, so let's say this is Shantanu's height. If I multiply that by 3, I get the giraffe's height. So let me divide, 1, 2. So Shantanu might look something like this. And if you took 3 times his height, so this is 1 time his height, 2 times his height, 3 times his height, you would get to the height of the giraffe. So that's what this first sentence tells us. Shantanu is 6 feet tall. So they tell us that this height right over here is 6 feet. Or another way of saying it is S is equal to 6 feet. How tall is the giraffe? Well, once again, S is equal to 6 feet. So the giraffe's height is equal to 3 times Shantanu's height, which we now know to be 6 feet. So 3 times 6 feet. So in feet, the giraffe's height is 3 times 6. Well, we know that 3 times 6 is 18. Giraffe's height is, and we're dealing with feet, so the giraffe's height is 18 feet. And you see that right over here. 6 feet plus another 6 feet plus another 6 feet, or 6 feet times 3, is going to get you to 18 feet.